9.6. Okay, now you know about this thing. you know about this antenna pigments, right? So how the energy is transferred? In what manner the energy or the electron is transferred? So that movement of electron, the moment it has activated the reaction center, the P6H0, it will move in a special manner. That manner, we call it the Z scheme. Or if you are American, you call it Z scheme. But please don't say Z, because kau bunyi macam redneck. You know redneck? Tak tahu nak cakap kat Malaysia, kat mana nak tengok redneck. Sebab semua sini tak coklat, hitam. You know redneck? Tak. Farmers lah, farmers kat US tu. Mungkin sebab dia sopan, dia tak pakai sunscreen semua. Lepas tu dia punya belakang tu jadi merah. To show that you are low class life, working on labor, hard work. Petani lah, macam kau. Okay. Ooh, that thing. The Z scheme, meaning that the electron, how do you say this? Remember, you have learned, there's a different way to say this, different way to say this. Ground state. Reaction center, P680. Excited state reaction center, P680. Okay. So, in essence, I don't want to look up. Aku cakap orang redneck, tengkuk aku yang sakit. So, we start in here, P680. Let's see whether I can remember lesson from 12 years ago. Kalau salah, cakap salah. Tak ada lah. But who's going to validate, right? So, this will be excited to become excited P680. Okay. So, now, this will be transferred to a series of electron carriers. Okay. So, you start with pheophytin, then you start with plastoquinone A, then you go to plastoquinone B, then you go to cytochrome B6F, then you go to plastocyanin. Is that correct? Then you will meet with, what is this? What's this? Yes, ground state P700. Then you're going to go up to P700 star. And then you will go to A0. This is actually chlorophyll, but we call it A0. Then we go to A1. Then you go to iron sulfur X. Then you go to iron sulfur A, then you go to iron sulfur B, then you go to ferredoxin, then you go to flavoprotein ferredoxin NADP plus reductase, then you go to NADP plus. Betul? Betul ke? Ooh, aku still ingat. Can you imagine? I have not taught you this. Kalau aku dah jauh, kau mati. Okay. Okay, since I can remember this, I expect you to know this jugalah. Ada kenapa aku tengok sendiri? Tak ada kan? Aku tahu je benda ni. Habislah engkau. Habislah engkau. Oh, by the way, dekat sini, cytochrome B6F has its own structure, which we'll see later. But in essence, this is the Z scheme. Z scheme. Okay, energy go up, then it hits the excitation, then it goes down. Cascade of reaction going downhill. Hence the word Hill's reaction, named by Robert Hill. Okay, then it goes
tak jauh pun. 68 nanometer to 700 nanometer. So there's only 220 nanometer worth of energy difference saja. Yeah. Then it will excite the second reaction center, the ground state P700. Then it gets excited. Then it will transfer to this cascade of reaction. So Fe means iron sulfur protein. These are all protein, okay? All of these are protein. But bear in mind with this one thing. Not all of them is integral protein. Some of them protein on the surface. For example, this thing, plastocyanin here. Plastocyanin is this guy. It's not in the thylakoid membrane. It's dekat luar. Dekat luar. And this ferredoxin, FNR and also NADP plus also in the stroma. They are not necessary in the integral membrane. Integral membrane protein only four, for sure. Okay, the one that you learned just now. Okay, and then get excited 700, pass down to chlorophyll. Chlorophyll A and, oh, by the way, A1 got a name actually. The name here is, let me see, can I remember that? Wikipedia, please. Phylloquinone. Phylloquinone. Transfer to iron sulfur X, iron sulfur A, iron sulfur B. Okay, right. Sometimes you will see in the form of plastoquinone A, plastoquinone B. That is simply the reduction state of it. If you learn chemistry, I'll give an example for plastoquinone. Plastoquinone, it's got three state of it. So plastoquinone is oxidized state. Oxidized state. Then you have plastosemiquinone. So the symbol becomes like this because it only have one electron coming to it, but the moment it is filled with hydrogen, it become plastoquinol. Or I think in the book it's called this PQH2. Plasto hydroquinone. So this become PH2. This is only PQ. No charges. Receive one electron. Receive two hydrogen. Still similar molecule, but now the molecule with different state of charges or reduction level attached to it. Okay? All right? Since I already said plastohydroquinone, maksudnya kau kena ingat lah kan? I think it's mentioned here somewhere. Okay? Alright. Okay. Oh, lupa. Kat sini. By the way, there's something happening in here as well. So this is why you got your H2O, right? You got your H2O got split. You got, I think, two electron for hydrogen. Is it for hydrogen? Oh, betul? Oh, oxygen. Yeah, this is where you got your oxygen. Two molecules of water is split because the moment it gets excited, this thing contains hole. Okay, this hole needs to be filled in by somebody. And who is that somebody? This thing steals electron from water. And then the water is oxidized. Because water is oxidized, H2O is split. When it is split, that's why you got oxygen. That's plus 4 hydrogen. Okay? Yeah. In case you don't, and finally, I just want to clarify on that H plus. H means, if you only H, it means hydrogen, 1 electron, plus 1 proton. If it says hydride, means hydrogen minus. No proton. If it says proton, it means hydrogen plus. So three levels of hydrogen we are talking about here. Are you talking about atomic hydrogen, like in the case here, or hydride of hydrogen, H minus, or proton of hydrogen, H plus? The splitting of water producing H plus. Proton of hydrogen. the reduction of plastoquinone is with the addition of atomic hydrogen, right? The hydride of hydrogen, H minus, this will you learn later. Some, not all molecules accept that, okay?